That duck over there
just scared the daylights out of me. He was resting over here. I was just watering my hydrangeas, my astilbe, and he came busting out of there. And I don't know if he's a mama duck, but he's lost. He's in my neighbor's yard, and I'm just following him. Is he wanting to lay eggs? What's going on? But that is a first. I did see some bunnies this morning, or a bunny coming into the yard, and I was still not dressed to go outside, but look at him. What is that all about? Maybe he is about to lay, she's about to lay her eggs, but wow. Incredible. So I'm gonna take a look at my neighbor's lovely container. I'm gonna take a look at what's going on over here. I'm a little afraid. Was she just resting? Is there a nest? It looks like something raised over there. I'm trying to zoom in. I'm a little afraid.
Hi everyone, it's Anne from Martin House Flowers. Welcome back. Welcome back to my channel, my garden, and I just wanted to take you along today. I haven't done a longer video in a while. It's not as windy as usual, but I have been away for 5 days, and I thought it would be great to take a walk around to see what the garden is doing. I went home, I go back there several times a year, and I was there for about 5 days, and my husband and his girls were kind enough to look after watering the garden. They watered my seedlings indoors under the grow lights, and obviously looked after Eddie. So I've got Eddie here on my lap, hoping that he behaves, because this is my second cut of the video. I'm gonna try to do a voiceover on this video because my second set of microphones are giving me a hard time again. So hope you can hear me okay. And at the end of this video, I have a special clip that I'm gonna share with you. One of my days spent in the Toronto area was a day trip I took to St. Catharines, which is the Niagara area of Ontario, and my uncle Rolly has a beautiful mature garden there, and it was such a thrill to see it, because the last time I visited his home was probably at least 10 years ago. And I've seen a lot of his development in his garden just over Facebook. And so he was kind enough to share with me a special tour around his garden. So I'm including some of those pictures at the end. So I hope you stick around for that, and that you join me as I take a walk around. So just to update you, in the background there is the greenhouse. It is at the stage of needing, waiting for the glass to get applied on. So unfortunately the weather has been, I think similar to other areas in the States, we've had just incredible wind storms, a little bit of rain, but it just wasn't safe to apply the glass over the Memorial Day weekend. So hopefully in the next, by the weekend and over the next week, my husband will have a chance to do that. He was very busy with the kids over the weekend. So, you know, and we've still got the raised beds to work on. So I will show you the progress of the two raised beds that have my cut flowers and the progress there. So thanks for joining me, and I hope you subscribe and stick around, and yeah, we'll take a walk. So we're in the backyard. Here are my delphiniums. So as you can see, there are more buds that have come up in the last 5 days. So I have three delphiniums here. This color, probably need to stake this. This color in front is a really rich purple, deep purple, and then the one in the back is a lighter blue. The daylilies that I replanted from the front bed are starting to bloom out. It's a bloom-struck hydrangeas with nice buds. This is the one that was just replaced last year, so it's only a year old, versus the two beside it are 2 years old. They're a big leaf hydrangea. I do come in with coffee grinds at least a couple times a week, just to try to slowly turn the soil a little more acidic. And in my other videos, you'll see that there are pictures of these hydrangeas that are a nice sort of rich fuchsia and purple. I wouldn't say that they've ever turned blue, but we'll see what happens this year. And I did come in with soil acidifier in the spring. Eddie is going to whine a little bit, so you might hear him in the background. Right, Eddie? So this is the back patio. I noticed that his little water dish over there, the robins were taking advantage of it, so they needed some water. So let's take a walk over to the raised beds. These boards over here, which have started to warp, my husband was noticing, are for the caps on the other beds back there that I'm not going to show you because they're such a mess. But I am ready to, this is where I plant out my tomatoes and herbs and lettuce. So you can see also the sweet peas that were planted about a month ago around that trellis or that obelisk. So these were the yellow tulips that I'm waiting to dry up, and then the lettuce will go in here. So I'll show you a clip of my lettuce, tray of lettuce that's inside. And during the windstorm, we still haven't taken the time here, unfortunately, to stake this one down. So this obelisk that my husband built, it's fallen a couple times, and unfortunately, you can see there one of the tomatoes broke. So I do need to move this over, because that tomato plant there needs to be under the obelisk. So I'm gonna try to avoid the unsightly beds that haven't been completed yet. So here's the stalk, which I'm going to get some netting set up so that they grow nice and straight. Unfortunately, the ones that have all fallen down were, I had two trays of stock and I grew them from seed, and the ones that are fallen were the tray that were on the bottom shelf of my potting bench. So they were seeking the light, and unfortunately I don't think I'm going to be able to straighten them out. I've done some research about whether or not I can get a second bloom if I cut those down. I don't think so. I think stock is a one and done, unlike snapdragons, which have already, these snapdragons were from the one of six trays that I had, because I had thinned out my snapdragons and repotted them. So they're doing pretty well. So here are the snapdragons that are nice and straight, straight up, and so they're doing pretty well. I haven't fertilized them since they were in their seed trays, so it's just from regular watering. So I think I'm pretty happy with them. Let's take a look at my red bud here. No, it's looking a little stressed. A little worried about that. Here's the Veronica that I planted, the royal candles. So they're blooming out, as you can see there. I'm gonna have to call Wasco Nursery where I picked up this red bud, because it's showing some signs of stress. I don't know if it's too much water or what's happening. I'm really worried because this is our second red bud back here. As you can see, the forsythia and the lilacs are still under netting, and we have yet to see any cicadas. And Michelle over in at Michelle's garden, her channel, I asked her, messaged her and asked if she's seen any cicadas, and apparently not yet. So look at the beautiful growth on my blue spruce here. My fat Albert is doing really well. These were planted in June of 22. We moved in the fall of 2021. And these were planted in June of 2022. So these have been in here for 2 years. My lilacs are finished. So I wanted to take you over to the other fat Albert I love. So I have several of these Black Hills spruce. They're really reliable. So it looks like those pine cones or spruce cones that were very red have gone a little bit purpley. I don't know if you can tell, but nice growth on these. Is my husband taking a break from, I think he's on his lunch break. Hi, honey. So I picked up this hanging geranium on clearance at Lowe's, and it's doing okay. Thing about geraniums is you need to constantly deadhead them. So it was a, you see here, I got the tag still. It was $26.98 and I paid half price for it because, I don't know, it wasn't that bad. But anyway, I tried to nurse it back to life, and I'm gonna fertilize it and deadhead it today. So there's the inside of the greenhouse and the positioning of where I'm going to put my chairs possibly. And I have a round table that's going in there. So I just wanted to show you here, we have a lot of birds. So I've put temporarily a cloche over the strawberries, the proven winter strawberries. And I think the other basket has some fruit on it. But when the glass is up and the door is up in the greenhouse, I won't need the cloche on there. That's just because we have a lot of birds, and I didn't want them feeding off the strawberries. So here you go. There is a strawberry. Oh my goodness. I can focus in on that. So that's really exciting. Those are going to be hanging on that side of the greenhouse on the, let's see, we face north in the backyard, so that's the east side. So it's around 10:30, 11 o'clock in the morning, and as you can see, we get nice morning sun back here, even though it's facing north. There's my geraniums that I planted in the containers on a previous video, and my sweet peas that have yet to bloom. So they're getting really tall and looking somewhat healthy. I can see some buds, so I think we're gonna get some flowers. What's the matter, buddy? I haven't put your cushion out, but you can sit on your sofa there. What's the matter? Are you stuck? Come on. What's the matter? Bye-bye. Eddie's inside. Let's take another look.
Wow, look at them. We're gonna try this again without screaming this time.
And if you look up close, there is someone in there taking care of her egg. Twice already, screamed the second time. First time she was walking out and I was scared, but the second time I actually screamed and the video cut. But there she is. Can I have footage of her egg? Can you hear? Can you hear, honey?
Yeah. Are you recording?
I am recording.
Thank you, Paul.
So here we are on the northeast side, behind the garage and next to the kitchen. After watering those hydrangeas, they've perked up nicely. It's shaded now, it's the afternoon. I took a lunch break, went out with my husband for a nice impromptu lunch. I pulled out the trays that need to start hardening off. So the learning with the stock and that one raised bed that I showed you earlier is that I can't put anything down below there in terms of plants hardening off, because they want to seek the light and then it ends up making their stalks all squirrely and crooked. And so these are going to need some fertilizing, because as you can see, the bells of Ireland are pretty yellow, so they need some iron. The lettuce is looking really good, except for this last batch over here, which is the crisp mint. So I'm gonna come in with some of that grow fertilizer that I use for my seedlings. So you can see now that the shade is over here, everything is perked up after a watering and without the direct sun. So can you see?
Closer, but do you see the duckling? Do you see the mama duckling's head there? I'm not gonna go closer, I'm just zooming in. But she's been there all afternoon, all morning. So I'll step away, nice and shaded for her. My really large hosta, the peach digitalis. And my variegated hostas that have grown a lot since last year. So I have three of those, and then the same blue one over here, which tend not to get as infected by the slugs. But I did come in and put some Cory's slug killer early spring. And the time to do that is when your hostas are still quite small, and then you can, you know, do a circle of the slug killer around the perimeter of the hosta and not have to move all the leaves. So here are my hydrangeas and the sweet peas. Look, it's finally climbing, this one over here, and hoping I'm gonna get a second flush of my bugleweed here. My awakening rose has grown quite a bit since last week. I'll give you some perspective here. And look at the hydrangea. It's got a bloom. These are the endless summer. They also last year really struggled on the sunny morning, but it's shaded now in the afternoon. They get morning sun on this side. This is the east side. So I repeated the hostas, same hostas over here, but you can see this one's so interesting because it's lost its variegation on the second half, the
the newer leaves. So that's really interesting. I don't know if it's because of the sun, morning sun, but and the pulmonaria back there that are finished blooming. What I like about the pulmonaria is when they were put in there, the hostas were just budding out from the ground. So I think it's going to be okay, even though they're kind of sheltered, hidden by the hosta. So I came in and pruned back some of the, or deadheaded some of the spent blooms from the peonies. I'm so glad that I took a short video a few days ago before I left. But I'm seeing some other buds there that might still come up. So the fragrance is still really beautiful. It's still so fragrant over here. And look at my rose back there. Kiss Me Kate, look at her climbing. She is doing really well. See, I love this allium here. It's still green, but this one over here is pretty done. And this is where the daylilies were. I actually pulled back quite a few. I think I have 1, 2, 3, 4, a fifth one back there. Front door. So I wanted to walk through my roses. So there's distant drums. It's getting a little bit of insect stress. So I think I can spray. I don't think we're getting rain till Saturday, but I will go ahead and put some organic spray on there, hopefully. But look what happens when it's at the end. It turns into quite a pink bloom versus the yellow and brownish color on the center and pink on the outside. I think those, they end up pink in the end, but really pretty. So here's my favorite earth angel. I'm gonna come down to the eye level, but look at all the new growth. Look at that. I just love the multi layers where it's pretty white on the outside and then soft pink on the inside. This one is probably one of the prettiest of the blooms. Look at that. Absolutely gorgeous. And there's some height on here. So it's supposed to be a 3x3. I think that's gonna grow pretty tall. So my Skyview hydrangeas have perked up a little bit from the water I gave them. But here are my Veronica that I have to say are looking more purple, darker purple this year versus last year when I planted the royal candles in the back that are supposed to be more blue. I remember saying these were more plum, more pinky plum, but they seem to be getting just a little deeper in color. So three identical ones planted, and of course the one in the middle is the last one to bloom. How strange is that? There's my peony from Bare Root. It's doing well. It's about, I don't know, 10 inches tall now. So I had planted three, one over here in the middle, and it's never came up. So it's not bad, 2 out of 3. There's the third one. Here's the other earth angel just budding up. The one at the front by the path is ahead, but look at that. Let's see if there's a fragrance. Yeah, it does. It has a slight rose fragrance, but look at all those buds. My Princess Spiraeas. I have 7 of them. 1, 2, 3, 4. The builder did put those in, and I have 3 around my bird bath. Look at that bird bath. It has already, the water has evaporated. I need to fill that up. Wow. So
So let me just take you over here by the front porch. There's the David Austin Charles Darwin. Now that this branch over here has fallen and seems to almost be finished its bloom, I am going to prune that back to here. That way it grows. It's sort of one of those odd anomaly branches that just grew out of character. So there's Charles Darwin. I think I missed the prettiest bloom. It's pretty much done, but there's more to come, and I'll be able to photograph those. There's the lavender and just the leaves of the daffodils in between. But as you can see, I started out with the same variety of English lavender, and some didn't make them, so I couldn't recall the names. So the three larger ones are all the same. This one on the far end and the one in the middle, I believe, are the same variety, but the two shorter ones, that one and that second one over there, are a different variety. But lavender are known for, there's my lavender printed pillows. But lavender are known for keeping mosquitoes away. So that's why, and they like full sun, so that's why I put them right by the front porch. So let's take a look over here. This is Tchaikovsky, which I planted a second one.
Look at how prolific it is. There's a bloom. Another gorgeous bloom, really pale yellow. Look at all those multiple buds.
Let's take a whiff. Oh, it's sort of lemony. Take another whiff. Yeah. You know, I wish someone would comment and describe to me what myrrh, the fragrance of myrrh, what a comparable fragrance is, because I've seen that before and I just don't know what that is. I'm wondering if that is what the smell is, but it's a little bit lemony, I have to say. It does have some stress, insect stress on it, on the first few, so I need to go in and spray that. It's getting quite warm. I'm gonna have to take off my denim shirt. There are the At Last roses from Proven Winners, which are, I would call them like dwarf roses. I'm glad I put two there. There's the snapdragons and this geraniums I planted. Snapdragons from seed. The phlox are finished. So there's Lady of Shalott. I think I showed its first bloom last week before the Memorial Day weekend. There's more of the peach digitalis. Some snapdragons. And here is Eden. Eden is finally going to, my climbing rose, it's finally going to bloom. First time this year. I planted these. They were the first roses to be planted, one of two first roses to be planted last June. And so this is almost a year, and there are multiple buds. So I'm so excited. I will be sure to show these in the next video. There's David Austin Scepter Dial. I did have one small bloom last week. There's another bud. The other three spiraeas. Obviously lots of sun here. That's why that birdbath is already dry. So this is I was telling my husband about this and he's so pleased as well. This is Carefree Wonder, and she is a pink rose and very soft pink. And she is in a cloche because this spring she was eaten down to the ground, completely hopeless, I thought, eaten down to the ground by the rabbit. But after I covered it, once I saw it, it had about an inch of growth on it. It has grown to the height of the cloche. So my husband suggested I just keep it on there because there's some really fine leaves, and
The rabbits are coming around every morning, so don't want to tempt them.
There's the Bobo hydrangeas, some lavender. We've already seen the delphiniums. These are the little lime hydrangeas that are doing really well. I want to take you to the quickfire fab hydrangeas that we planted last fall that are really tall but have not shown any blooms yet. And they're supposed to be the first to bloom in the spring, summer. But look at New Dawn. Look at all the buds. Look at them all. What a difference a year makes. Incredible. Look at them. I just took a whiff and I don't smell anything. So maybe when they open up, there'll be a scent, but so far nothing. As you can see, they're super thorny. I don't know if I can train this one to climb up here. I don't know. To go look for some zip ties. So the last thing I wanted to show you on this tour are my new roses that were planted just in the last 2 weeks. There's David Austin Litchfield Angel. So they've leafed out really nicely. There's the other Tchaikovsky. And there's Rosanna Jacobs. So Tchaikovsky, as you can recall, is a creamy yellow. Rosanna Jacobs is a yellow one. Litchfield Angel is a blushy, creamy white. Desdemona's going in by David Austin if she ever arrives. This is Parfuma Madame Anisette, which is a creamy white. There is Olivia Rose Austin, the two in the back. In the front, we have White Diamond. She's looking really pretty, healthy. David Austin, Emily Bronte. Easy Spirit. And my two Queen of Sweden roses that were getting some stress, some little branches eaten up by the rabbits. So all three of these. Oh, sorry, that one back there was Princess Alexandra of Kent. The one in the front. The one in the front here is Easy Spirit. Princess Alexandra of Kent is going in when she arrives, bare root. But those two are doing better since I've put the cloche on. And my row of cat's pajamas. And look at that bumblebee. Look at that. So that's it, everyone. I just wanted to take you for a walk through the garden and update you on everything that's blooming. I hope you have a wonderful day. It's going to be a beautiful mid-70s day, mid-20s in Celsius, and I hope we can get together again soon on my next video. Thanks for joining us. Bye-bye.